Hi students, this is Sara Ravichandran, Assistant Professor in Department of Media Studies, Christnagar College, Trivandrum. Welcome to our photojournalism class. Today we are going to discuss about features of photojournalism. Photojournalism is an effective way of telling stories and disseminating information to a diverse group of people. Compared to text or plain articles, photos are more attractive. People are drawn to them because the images are colorful and interesting. Best of all, photojournalism works because it does not rely only in words and phrases. Photographs paints real pictures of events and emotions. Photojournalist's eye is informed by a principle that is often defined as the decisive moment. Photographer and artist Henri Cartier-Bresson coined the term decisive moment to describe the convergence of critical visual elements in time and space. According to Bresson, sometimes there is one unique picture whose composition possesses such rigor and richness and whose content so radiant outward from it that this single picture is a whole story in itself. But this rarely happens. The elements which together can strike sparks out at a subject and are often scattered, either in terms of time and space, and bring them together by force is stage management, and I feel cheating. And I do agree to Bresson's concept of cheating, because if we stage something or dramatize an event, it will lose its life. And according to renowned photographer Raghu Roy, a photographer should take a picture from the heart and not from the head. And there is no need for a costly camera or expensive lenses. All one has to do is to correct the energy of a subject. That is enough to secure a good picture. According to Mark M. Hancock, a journalist tells stories. A photographer takes pictures of nouns. That is the difference. Journalist captures verbs and photographers captures nouns. Noun means people, place and things. And a photojournalist takes the best of both and locks it into the most powerful medium available, that is frozen images or still images. So there are differences between a common journalist and a photojournalist. There are differences between a photographer and a photojournalist.
So mere taking of picture is not, it is photography. It is not photojournalism. Photojournalism is something far from that. Now we are moving to the features of photojournalism.
Photojournalism has qualities that make it different from other branches of photography. This factor helps photojournalists come up with images that stir the mind and catch the soul. And first point related to features of photojournalism is relevant. The main objective of photojournalism is to tell a story better than the text or write-up that usually accompanies the photograph. Therefore, it should capture images that have meaning or relevance to the story being told. Next point is editorial value. You may have learned about the factors affecting reporting, factors affecting or elements related to reporting. There you learn the timeliness, the proximity, the prominence, the money, the currency, like that. And all these things merge here to make a newsworthy photograph. And that is what we call by the editorial value or news value. I move to the next point, that is photojournalism is timely. I just all about this, right? The timeliness. And again, I am repeating the point, that is photojournalism is timely. Photojournalism should tackle current issues. It should feature something that's on the news or some people, the people are talking about. They are very relevant in the news, current news. This will make the images more interesting to the audience or readers. In photojournalism, it should tackle current issues. That is an important thing. If you don't go behind current issues, definitely the photographs may not be having much news value. So, next point is photojournalism is objective. Objectivity is another important factor related to photojournalism. Photojournalism should not be biased or it should not take the sides. It should, it does not take sides. That is a principle or ethic behind photojournalism. Therefore, the images should accurately show events as they are. Some photographers, however, they argue that it is difficult or completely to be objective is quite difficult. According to them, the term honest is more appropriate in describing photojournalism. No matter what a photojournalist believes in, whether he prefers to be objective or honest, the most important thing is for him to present the image as it is. And the secret is not to force the situation. For example, a photojournalist shooting a burial scene, and if he forced the subject to cry or shed tears, definitely it is a dramatic effect, it creates a dramatic effect, but it loses its genuinity. So dramatizing such emotions are is very boring, and you could capture emotions, real emotions, in a candid manner, candidly, right? And next point is prominence. For the same occurrence, people in the public eye have higher news value than obscure people, than common men. You can see, notice the picture here. That is why this picture becomes the picture holds the factor prominence, right? The person is seen here as very prominent, and you know prominence is something associated with people from sports, people from cinema, people from politics, even extraordinary people among us, right? And next factor relating to features of photojournalism is. Photojournalism is narrative in nature. Narrativity is very important related to photojournalism. Photojournalism works best if it is presented in a narrative manner. The photos should come with a short write-up or article stating important factors about the incident or event. It should tell a story. So, telling something, photos can be narrated in different ways. Either the photo can stand alone, or it can be presented as a photo essay. Or a photo can be accompanied with a caption or a cut line which describes the photographs, and it can be having a short text associated with that. So narrating a story in different manner. And next about aesthetically interesting. Next point is aesthetically interesting. A photo definitely should be aesthetically interesting, right? Otherwise people won't look onto it. And photojournalists follow certain photographic principles that are intended to help them produce photos that catch the attention of internal audiences. And people with the right focus, the photos, like people should capture photos with right focus, right angle, or not right angle, in the correct sense, the angle, and the focus and the color will attract more people than those with blurry or smudgy or unfocused. So aesthetically interesting, some photographs attracts people because it is aesthetically interesting. And next point is capturing actions. I have already discussed the point that photojournalists capture verbs, and verbs may have actions in that. Action photographs give a life to the photograph, and opposed to word, even the photojournalists capture nouns. We can't say that they avoid nouns. They may capture nouns, even though they are more inclined to verbs or action photographs. And this action inside the photograph make a kind of involvement from the reader, or it attracts people more to the photograph. It have a life. That is the main point inside that. And next is impact. Impact is another important factor related to photojournalism. What impact the photograph made on the readers, or what is the importance of the story it holds? If you have a issue, very small issue. Inside in your community, and it's not like a communal violence, I mean a small issue besides your home or besides your residence, or not besides, it can be something related to your residence association or colony. It may not maybe that much impact, admit having that much impact like a communal violence, or you may you can just relate to the current stories going in or going on, right? Something related to gold smuggling and minister and all. The bureaucracy, the involvement of bureaucracy in this gold smuggling issue, and it gave rise to a great protest from the people, common man, and even from the political parties. So this makes the issue more, the impact of the story makes it a more important thing, right? And this is why we are discussing this gold smuggling more than any other gold smuggling. Its relation to nation security, integrity, everything, right? So this makes the story more important. And so the impact of the photo story is very important. What impact? You can see a photo here. What is the impact? What should be next? That is the question that comes to the viewer's mind while watching this photograph. And next is technical value. Whatever the photo is, if you don't have the technical value inside that, if you lose the clarity photograph, or you if you don't have a it is a small G photograph or it's unclear, definitely the any publisher can't help you. They can't publish it, right? How a photo publisher or a newspaper publisher or a magazine publisher can publish such a unclear, technically low quality photograph? Never, it's never going to happen. No one is going to broadcast your photograph. No one is going to publish your photograph. So whatever the photo important is photograph, or whatever the photograph process, the quality of the process, it should be related to technical quality. So technical quality is another important factor, another important feature of photojournalism. You should possess technical quality inside your photograph. And mere technical quality won't do, but technical quality is something going parallel to that. And this is all about the features of photojournalism. Hope you are very clear about the features of photojournalism. And next class, we will be definitely discussing on features of photojournalists. It's almost the same, even though we have discussed in detail. Hope you understand what I have already taught you in this class. Thank you. Here, signing off, your teacher, Tara.